بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله واستغفر لذنبك وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات وقال الله سبحانه وتعالى ألا تعبدوا إلا الله إني لكم منه نذير وبشير وأن استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه وقال الله سبحانه وتعالى قل إنما أنا بشر مثلكم يوحى إلي أنما إلهكم إله واحد فاستقيموا إليه واستغفروه وقال الله تعالى وإلى عاد أخاهم هودا قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيري إلى قوله سبحانه وتعالى ويا قوم استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه. In these ayats I've read from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we find all of these ayats, they have two things in common. Two things are mentioned in these verses, these four verses I read from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the first of those two things is proof of at-tawheed, proof of the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in worship. Or al-amr, order and a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this order and this command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is from the greatest of the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The greatest of the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is because of it Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created the heavens and the earth. This command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is because of this command that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala خلق الجن والإنس. For this purpose Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created mankind and the jinn. This order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the primary reason behind Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending the anbiya wa rusul from Nuh to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the primary reason behind Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending down al-kutub, sending down the books, the heavenly revealed books. This order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is because of it Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala divided mankind into two categories, kafir wa mu'min, disbeliever and believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is because of it Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created paradise and the hellfire. This order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the order of Tawheed. So the ayats which I read, every single one of them had proof of Tawheed or the command of Tawheed to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without associating partners with Him. So in the first ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, fa'alam, have knowledge and know there's no deity worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the second ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Alla ta'budu illallah. Do not worship except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inni lakum minhu nadhirun wa bashir. I am unto you a warner and a glad giver of glad tidings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the third ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Say to them, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Innama ana basharun mitlukum. I am a man just like you. But it's been revealed to me, wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that ilahakum, that your Lord or your God is one, proof of Tawheed. And in the last ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about Hud, when He sent him to Ad, and the first command He gave them was what? Worship Allah. you have no other deity that truly deserves to be worshipped by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second thing which all these ayat they have in common is a commandment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every single one of these four ayah, a commandment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of istighfar, seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in the first ayah, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no, la ilaha illallah. What comes after it? Wastaghfir li dhanbika wa lil mu'minina wal mu'minat. Ask Allah for forgiveness for your sins and the sins of the believing men and the believing women. In the second ayah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what follows after it? وَأَنْ إِسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ. Seek forgiveness of your Lord. In the third ayah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them, I'm a man like you, but it's been revealed to me that the one that truly deserves to be worshipped is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says, وَاسْتَقِيمُوا إِلَيْهِ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا. Be upright and seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the last ayah, after Hud, he ordered his people from Aad to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He ordered them again and said, Ya qawm istaghfiru rabbakum. My people, seek the forgiveness of your Lord. So all these ayat contain Tawheed, oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and istighfar, to show that between worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his oneness and istighfar, seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is a bond and a link. And you find this in many verses in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And not only in many verses in the book of Allah, even in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when we look at the adhkar that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us, the remembrances the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us, we find in it the link and the connection between Tawheed, worshipping Allah in his oneness, and istighfar. From the things the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he taught us, the adhkar is the end or the conclusion of any gathering, any meeting, be at work, be at home, be a business meeting outside, that the conclusion of the meeting, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, should conclude with his dua. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. The end, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the dua to say, how perfect you are, O Allah. And I praise you. I bear witness there's no deity worthy of worship in truth except for you. And how does the dua end? Astaghfiruka. And I seek your forgiveness and I repent unto you. The wudu which you make, what is the dua or the dhikr the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us to make when we make the wudu? The dua is, or the dhikr, the remembrance is, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la wa ashhadu anna muhammadan abdu wa rasuluh. And what is the end of the dua? Allahumma ja'alni min at-tawwabin wa ja'alni min al-mutatahhirin. Again, tawheed and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness. The dua we make on concluding the salah in tashahud. What is the dhikr the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us? So the dua is, Allahumma ghfir li ma qaddamtu wa ma akhartu. Allah, forgive me that which I have done in the past and that which I will do in the future. Wa ma asrartu wa ma a'lantu. And that which I've done openly and that which I've concealed. Wa ma asraftu. And that which I transgressed in. Wa ma anta a'lamu bihi minni. And that which you know better than me. Anta al-muqaddim wa anta al-mu'akhir. You, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're the one that sent forth and you're the one that withhold. And the end of the dua is what? La ilaha illa ant. Istighfar and tawheed, they go hand in hand. Tawheed and istighfar. And that's why Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, قَدْ ثَبَتَ دَائِرَةُ الْإِسْتِغْفَارِ بَيْنَ أَهْلِ التَّوْحِيدِ. The important role of asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness is something that is established amongst the people of Tawheed. And we are ummah of Tawheed, worshiping Allah ta'ala in his oneness. And he went on to say that وَإِقْتِرَانُهَا بِالشَّهَادَةِ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَى اللَّهِ. The fact that istighfar is connected or linked with La ilaha illallah is something established min awwalihim ila akhirihim, from the first of the people to the last of the people. So the question is now, my brothers and sisters, why the connection
between at-tawheed and istighfar. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullahu ta'ala mentions the reason, the important reason, which is what? He said, فَالشَّهَادَةُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. You bear witness, there's no deity worthy of worship in truth except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بِالشَّهَادَة يعني إِذَا كَانَ بِالصِّدْقِ وَيَقِينِ. If you say in truthfulness and with certainty, تُذْهِبُ الشِّرْكِ, it wipes out shirk completely. جُلَّهُ وَدِقَّهُ, major of it and the minor of it. عَمْدَهُ وَخَطَأَهُ, that which you do on purpose and that which you did by accident. And the major of it and the small of it. This tawheed, the shahada, wipes it out completely. And that's why when the Sahabi came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who had transgressed before Islam against the Muslim excessively, he said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I only enter Islam with a condition. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, what is your condition? He said, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me that which I did before Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam laughed and said, أَلَا تَعْلَمْ يَا عَمَرْ أَنَّ الْإِسْلَامِ يَهْدِمُ أَوْ يَجُبُّ مَا قَبْلَهُ. Do you not know that Islam, it wipes out and knocks out whatever came before it? So this tawheed, it removes shirk completely. And then he went on to say, وَالْإِسْتِغْفَارِ, to show the connection. As for istighfar, يَمْحُو مَا بَقِيَ مِنْ عَثَرَاتِ الشِّرْكِ. As for the little remnants of the shirk, the istighfar, it erases it completely. وَيَمْحُ, and istighfar, it erases the shu'ab, the roots or the branches, afwan, the branches of shirk, which is dhunub, which is disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's when you find also in many ahadith, this connection between tawheed, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his oneness, and istighfar. The hadith al-Qudsi in a Tirmidhi, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya Ibn Adam, O the son of Adam, إِنَّكَ مَا دَعُوتَنِي وَرَجَوْتَنِي غَفَرْتُ لَكَ مَا كَانَ مِنْكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي. O son of Adam, you have never called upon me, made invocations, and hoped in me, except I forgive you for whatever you do, and I do not care. Ya Ibn Adam, O the son of Adam, لَوْ بَلَغَتْ ذُنُوبُكَ عَنَانَ السَّمَاءِ. If your sins were to be so much, they reach the heavens. ثُمَّ اسْتَغْفَرْتَنِي, and you ask me to forgive you, غَفَرْتُ لَكَ, I will forgive you. يَا إِبْنَ آدَمْ لَوْ أَتَيْتَنِي بِقُرَابِ الْأَرْضِ خَطَايَا. If you was to come with sins and errors as vast as the earth, ثُمَّ لَقِيتَنِي, and you meet me, Allah Ta'ala, يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ, لَا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا, without associate partners with me, لَأَتَيْتُكَ, I will come to you with the likes of this earth, maghfiratan, in forgiveness. The connection again between istighfar and tawheed. And this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in it is great benefit for the sabab of istighfar, the causes of forgiveness. Because this Ramadan, we fasted iman wa ihtisaban. Why? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever fasts Ramadan, iman wa ihtisab, it will be forgiven. Standing Ramadan, pray iman wa ihtisab, it will be forgiven. Laylatul Qadr, iman wa ihtisab, it will be forgiven. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, for the dua, he taught us to make Laylatul Qadr is what? Allahumma innaka afun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna. So if we want forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, contained in this hadith are the three causes of forgiveness. The first is what? Hope. Because Allah ta'ala said, you've never hoped in me. So long as you hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you'll be forgiven by Allah azza wa jal. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ibadi, O my servants, alladhi asrafu ala anfusihim. Those, not they just saying, they've wronged themselves excessively in ways you could not imagine. La taqnatu min rahmatillah. Do not ever give up hope concerning the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a. Allah forgives all sins. First thing, hope. The second thing is istighfar. Ask Allah to forgive you. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the same hadith, if you was to come to Allah azza wa jal and your sins was to reach the heavens, thumma istaghfartani, Allah said, and you just ask me to forgive you, ghafartu lak, I'll forgive you. And the last thing is tawheed, oneness of Allah azza wa jal. Because in the end of hadith, if you was to come yawm al-qiyamah with the vastness of the earth in sins, and you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, la tushrik bi shay'a, you do not associate partners with me, I'll come with it, the likes of it, in forgiveness to you. Subhanallah. So there's a strong connection between a tawheed, because a tawheed, it wipes out the shirk, and istighfar, it wipes out the sin. Wa aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lak wa sa'il muslimin.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. La udwana illa ala al-zalimin wal aqiba lil muttaqeen.
Other than the connection, we should know the makana, the high and the lofty status of istighfar and the benefits of istighfar. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to make istighfar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 100 times a day. And Allah ta'ala has forgiven him of his previous and future sins, but yet will increase in istighfar. It's important. You're driving, you're walking, you're sitting, always have upon your tongue, astaghfirullah, 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 astaghfirullah. Very important. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to show the makana, the status of istighfar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that whoever ya'mal su'an aw yadhlimu nafsahu, whoever ever does an evil act or oppresses himself, thumma yastaghfirillah, and then he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him. In this ayah, for the Arabs and those who know Arabic, you know the shart, jumla shartiyah, this is a condition, thumma yastaghfirillah, that he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness. What is the answer to that condition? Yajidillah. Definitely we'll find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ghafoor rahima. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مُعَذِّبُهُمْ, will never punish them, وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ, and they seek forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This Ramadan that just went, part of the activities of Ramadan is sahur. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تَسَحَّرُوا, have the sahur. Some people lazy, don't go for sahur, but it's barakah. فَإِنَّ فِي السَّحُورِ بَرَكَةً. And part of the activities we mentioned in the khutbah Ramadan of sahur, which is an abandoned sunnah, face the qibla and do what? Do istighfar. Because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the people of Jannah, Allah ta'ala said, قَلِيلٌ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ. They don't sleep except for very little in the night. وَبِالْأَسْهَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. The time of sahur, before fajr, even if you cannot get off on the night prayer, set your alarm clock, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 5 minutes. Before fajr, wake up and say, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. These are the attributes of the people of Jannah. Wabil ashari, and the time of suhur, hum yastaghfirun. And that's why you find the Salaf, do you know what time they used to visit each other? Most of the time, they wanted to visit each other now, after Maghrib, after Asr, anytime. The Salaf, they used to visit each other, and they'll know, they'll find their brother awake. You know the time they visit each other? Waqtu sahar, before fajr. And if they find him asleep, they used to be shocked. Afi hadha alwaqt yanam al-abdul muslim. Does a Muslim sleep at this time, the time of sahur? Not just in Ramadan. So this is the status of al-istighfar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ, that Nuh, he said to his people, ask forgiveness of your Lord. Verily is forgiven. يُرْسِلُ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدُكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. A man came to Hassan al-Basri, rahimahullah ta'ala, وَشَكَ إِلَيْهِ الْجَدَبِ وَجَاءَ إِلَيْهِ آخَرُ وَشَكَ إِلَيْهِ الفقر وجاء إليه الآخر وشك إليه جفاف بستانه وجاء إليه الآخر وشك إليه عدم الأولاد. Four different people came to Hassan al-Basri with four different problems. One came complaining about lack of rain or farming. The other one came complaining about poverty. The third one came complaining about how his bustan, his vegetation, or his plantation is just dry, no water. And the last one came complaining about lack of children, not having any children. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who don't have children amongst us, bless them with children. And not just children, bless them with pious children. Because the issue, even if you have one, is not kathara but barakah, to be blessed. Blessed children, ameen. So these four people, the first one, Hassan al-Basri, he told him, istaghfirullah. Ask Allah to forgive you. The second one, he said, istaghfirullah. The third one, istaghfirullah. The fourth one, istaghfirullah. And then he recited the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So istighfar is the answer for all these four different problems. فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُ رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا يُرِسِلُ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. Ask forgiveness of Allah Azza wa Jal. It will send down the sama, meaning rain upon you, يعني in abundance. وَيُمْدِدُكُمْ. It will multiply you. بِأَمْوَالٍ. In wealth. If you want wealth, استغفر الله. And baneen. And in children, وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ. And he'll make for you plantations, vegetation, jannati wanhara, and rivers. The answer is istighfar. And this is some of the benefits or the fruits in this dunya. What about the akhirah? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Tuba, glad tidings, يوم القيامة, لِمَنْ وَجَدَ فِي صَحِيفَتِهِ الْإِسْتِغْفَارِ. Glad tidings to the one, يوم القيامة, he finds in his book much istighfar. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من أسره أو من يحب أن تسره. The one who loves to be happy بصحيفتي يوم القيامة, to be happy when he sees that book يوم القيامة of deeds, فليكثر من الاستغفار. Let him do استغفار consistently. استغفار consistently. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من قال أستغفر الله الذي أستغفر الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه. Important dua. Whoever makes this dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive him all his sins. وَإِنْ فَرَّ مِنَ الزَّحَفِ. Even if he ran from the battle, which is a major, major, major sin. So everything should begin and conclude with what? Istighfar. The surah, which was an announcement or a sign of the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was what surah? Surah An-Nasr. And how does Surah An-Nasr end? إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ. Subhanallah. Ended with istighfar, the greatest pillar of al-Islam after shahada, which is this salah. What do we say after assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah? Allahu Akbar, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make of min al-mustaghfirin, those who seek forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and forgive us of our dhunub and our sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to be from those yatubuna ila Allahi tawbatan nasuha. And most importantly, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who live upon tawheed and die upon tawheed. Because so long as you die on this, inshallah ta'ala, falaka al-jannah. But along with that, couple istighfar.